ఆచార్య నాగార్జున యూనివర్సిటీలో ఇండియన్ ఎకనామిక్ అసోసియేషన్ ఐఈఏ 100వ సమావేశం ప్రారంభమైంది. ఈ సమావేశాన్ని రాష్ట్రపతి కోవింద్ ప్రారంభించారు. ఈ సందర్భంగా సీఎం చంద్రబాబు మాట్లాడారు. 2020 నాటికి దేశంలో 3వ స్థానంలో ఏపీని నిలుపుతామని సీఎం చంద్రబాబు స్పష్టం చేశారు. ఏపీకి 1000 కిలోమీటర్ల సముద్ర తీరం ఉందని, ఏపీలో అపారమైన వనరులు ఉన్నాయన్నారు ఆయన. 3 ఏళ్లుగా వృద్ధి రేటు సాధిస్తున్నామని, రాష్ట్ర విభజన వల్ల ఆర్థిక సమస్యలు ఎదుర్కొంటున్నామని ఆర్థికవేత్తలు విలువైన సూచనలు ఇవ్వాలని చంద్రబాబు కోరారు.
శ్రీఎస్ఎల్ నరసింహం గారు, గెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆనర్ నోబెల్ లారేట్ బంగ్లాదేశ్ ఆనరబుల్ ప్రొఫెసర్ మహమ్మద్ యూనస్ గారు, సెంటరీ కాన్ఫరెన్స్ ప్రెసిడెంట్ ఐఏ డాక్టర్ రంగరాజన్ గారు, ప్రెసిడెంట్ ఐఏ ప్రొఫెసర్ సుభాదేవ్ తొరట్ గారు, ఆనరబుల్ మినిస్టర్ గంటా శ్రీనివాసరావు గారు, వైస్ ఛాన్సలర్ ఆచార్య నాగార్జున యూనివర్సిటీ ప్రొఫెసర్ రాజేంద్ర ప్రసాద్ గారు, సెక్రటరీ అండ్ ట్రెజరర్ ఐఏఈ అనిల్ కుమార్ ఠాకూర్ గారు, డిస్టింగ్విష్డ్ ఇన్వైటీస్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ అండ్ స్టూడెంట్స్ అండ్ మీడియా, ఐఎమ్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ. దిస్ విల్ బి ది హిస్టరీ. దిస్ ఈజ్ 100 ఇండియన్ ఎకనామిక్ అసోసియేషన్ ఈజ్ బీయింగ్ హెల్డ్ ఇన్ ఆచార్య నాగార్జున యూనివర్సిటీ. ఐఎమ్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ ఫర్ ఇట్. ఐఎమ్ ప్రౌడ్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్. ఇఫ్ యు సీ ఆన్ ది డయాస్ అవర్ ప్రెసిడెంట్ is a very excellent intellectual and also committed for the poorest of the poor. He know and also he faced the problems of the poverty. After he became president of India, he visited 20 states so far within 4 or 5 months time. That is his commitment for the national development. I am very happy. Even for Andhra Pradesh, he visited 3 times. Third time, this is third time. First time, he came to Tirupati for Lord Balaji Darshan. Second time, he came to Visakhapatnam Navy event. Third time, he came Acharya Nagarjuna University for Economic Association. I am very happy. I am thankful to him. Our governor is here. I am also welcoming him. And also we are the important guest today. Professor Muhammad Yunus is a great achiever in his career. He organized all poor women in Bangladesh and ultimately he started Gramina Bank. It has helped for eradication of poverty. Just like our Dhakra, he has done great work for the women empowerment. I really appreciate him and welcome here. Even our Rangarajan, you may not you have to recollect when he was RBI governor after retirement, I requested Vajpayee, the then Prime Minister, to appoint him to spare his services for Andhra Pradesh development as governor. He agreed and he supported. I remember that days he used to guide me on economics and also finance. Today, I am also an economic student. That's why last time 99th Indian Economic Association conference was held in Tirupati. Then I requested them, why can't you have 100th also in Andhra Pradesh, that to Acharya Nagarjuna University. That is my request at that time. I wanted to promote this university in a big way. Even from Nagarjuna, the name itself, if you see, Acharya Nagarjuna started university at that time. He promoted Buddhism from here to overseas, either South Korea or Japan or China, Thailand, all countries, he promoted Buddhism from this place. That is the historical importance for this place. If you see the importance of the conference, geography makes us neighbors. History makes us friends. Economic makes us partners. This is John F. Kennedy. This is a fact. If you see Gandhi's statement, combination of ethics and economics is deadly. We advocate ethics politics, ethical politics. This is what Mahatma Gandhi was said long back. I am very happy today. There are so many events, seminars, 4 days we are all staying here. Excellent brains on economics. You are going to have brainstorming and ultimately you are giving your ideas for the nation. So it is the best avenue. And also I am telling you, this is the best place in India on knowledge. If you see anywhere in the world today, we are very strong in information technology. Out of 4 IT professionals all over the world, 1 is from India. Among Indians out of 4, 1 is from Andhra Pradesh, mainly from this place. That is the strength of this area. Now, as you rightly mentioned, our President has rightly mentioned, so many issues they are discussing here. And ultimately, special focus on Andhra Pradesh economy and also recent development of Andhra Pradesh, this conference is going to discuss. I am very happy for that. And also if you see here, 2017 is a historical year for so many reasons. Government of India recently, they have taken a decision of demonetization is one economic reform. And also if you see GST, long back, so many years we are waiting, now it has come. And also if you see GDP, I can tell you, all economists are here, only the country in the world which can aim to have a double digit growth, that is India, nowhere in the world it is possible, even in future. I am very strong in this. And also if you see here, we are inherited some of the problems, bad loans, even this issue we have to discuss here. Even government of India recently, if you see, even the Banking Regulation Act was amended to allow the Reserve Bank of India to crack down on the loan defaulters. In addition, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code was invoked to deal with sick companies, with realty firms facing the maximum heat. Banks, especially state-owned, have been saddled with non-performing assets, mainly across 6 major sectors, steel, power, roads, highways and telecom sectors, are in the process of revival. Given the pile-up of bad loans, that threatens to negatively affect their growth. NPAs held by Indian banks have crossed 10 lakh crores. The Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code, IBC 2016, was enacted for time-bound insolvency resolution process and to prevent unscrupulous, undesirable persons from misusing or vitiating the provisions of the code. In addition, in October, the government also announced 2.11 lakh crores capital infusion into state-owned banks as part of a broad plan to create thousands of new jobs, raise income, boost investment and quicken growth in the border economy. It may, in many ways, 2017 was a landmark year for the Indian economy as the budget's presentation was advanced. Earlier we used to pass budget in the March and April. Even sometimes Even final budget has been approved during May. I am very happy now, 1 month they have preponed, that is 1st of February budget they are going to place. On the base of the state governments can have their own budget. First time railway budget has been merged with general budget. This is also 92 years practice they have changed. This is a very good decision. Even ease of doing business, we are number one last year in the country. Even this year we will be number one. And at the same time, country wise, if you see, they have jumped nearly 30 places by reaching 100th position. This is where all over the world people are visualizing India in a big way. Even recently, Moody's Investors, Global Rating Agency, Moody's Investors Service upgraded India's sovereign ratings to BAA2 from its lowest investment grade, BAA3, after a gap of 13 years. These are all very interesting observations. Even recently you are watching, I don't have any doubt, India will become one among three great economies, big economies in the world. America, China and India, these are all the economies in the near future. So with all these things, India is having a strength. You are all aware, we are very strong in English. We are very strong in technology. Apart from that, demographic dividends. I can say all over the world, only India is having the strength of youngsters, young India. So this is the biggest advantage, hope on youngsters. I am confident India will become superpower in the near future. Coming to Andhra Pradesh, I wanted to place before all our dignitaries here, all economists, bifurcation has taken place 3.5 years old. It is a 3.5 years baby. We have prepared a vision document. By 2022, we wanted to be one among top three in the country. By 2029, we wanted to be number one in the country, not only in development with happiness as index. 2050, Andhra Pradesh will be the preferred destination, and also we wanted to be best state in the country itself. For this we had 7 missions, 5 grids, 5 campaign modes. We are having so many advantages. We are having sea coast nearly 1,000 kilometers. There is a history long back from Andhra Pradesh, from Amaravati. Country used to export Amaravati as a logistics hub for Southeast Asia. We are having good rivers. Now there is a change in power sector also because of solar energy is coming. It is a disruptive technology in a big way. On knowledge, our people are very strong. We are very creative. I can say in India, best place for knowledge is Andhra Pradesh. I don't have any doubt about it. That is the biggest strength for Andhra Pradesh we are having. Ultimately, if you see all these things, recently, 3 years economy, 2014-15, first year bifurcation, our growth rate is 8.51, all India 8.01. 2015-16, our growth rate is 10.95, all India 7.11. 16-17, our growth rate is 11.61. Even this half yearly, if you see, our growth rate is 11.37, all India 5.8. So always we are ahead of all India, but our base is very low. And also after bifurcation, still Andhra Pradesh is the lowest per capita income state in the South India itself. So I am requesting all friends who assembled here, you give me some ideas. I am very strong. Future is only knowledge. Even His Excellency Yunus Ahmad has rightly mentioned, wealth has been created. but that wealth is not distributed or getting for the poorest of the poor or equally or inclusive growth rate. But for this, there is only one answer. Through knowledge, through education, we can do anything. That is happening today. With knowledge, you can do wonders in the near future. As on today, it is very inspiring time also. One is knowledge, and with the technology and Internet of Things, real-time decisions you can take, we can do anything real-time. This is where I want to quote Lee Kuan Yew quotation, good economics coupled with good governance, guided by good politics, will lead the nation to great heights. This is how Singapore, small country, has built one of the superpower or super highest economy in the world as on today. So, with all these things, youngsters are here, economists are here, you have to guide the country, you have to give excellent ideas. I don't have any doubt about it. Even Narendra Modi's leadership, you are saying, Modi rating also, that agency has given very good rating.